由国度使徒中心网络举办的天上法庭特会，今年二月底邀请到美国使徒 Robert Henderson 来台，说明个人如何透过天上法庭运作，取消撒旦的控告，恢复上帝对个人、家庭、城市，甚至是国家的命定。
The court of heaven is a new concept for a lot of people. One of the questions that we get is how do we present a case in the courts of heaven? And that's a very legitimate question. First of all, Romans 8:26 says that when I don't know how to pray as I ought, the Holy Spirit helps me. He helps my weakness.He helps me in my infirmity so that out of the revelation of the Spirit, I'm able to come and present cases to the Lord. So we have to have a real dependence upon hearing, feeling, and sensing what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. But having said that, one of the best ways to present a case in the courts is to bring God in remembrance of something that He has said to us.For instance, the Bible says in Isaiah 43:26, put me in remembrance, let us contend together, state your case that you may be acquitted. In other words, one of the ways we bring a case is by calling God into remembrance. Now that can be a promise in His word. In other words, Lord, you've said this in your word, so I'm bringing you into remembrance concerning what you've said in your word. And we can even say this, Lord, I'm comingBefore your courts, and I'm asking that you remember the word that is spoken, and that based on this word, you would grant me my request. Another way is prophetic words that we have received. In other words, if someone has given us a prophetic word, or we have heard something from God, we can come before the Lord and we can say, Lord, on the basis of this prophetic word, this which has been promised to me that I believe is from the Lord.I come and I ask for this to be a reality in my life. And I began to present a case before him based on the prophetic word that's been spoken to me or the prophetic word that I myself have heard. So you can bring the promises of God, you can bring the prophetic word. A third thing you can do is that you can remind the court of what Jesus has done.For instance, if you need healing in your body, you can come before the court and you can say, Lord, I am reminding the court that when Jesus died on the cross, that he bore away my sicknesses and he carried away my pains. And I'm asking on the basis of what Jesus has done, that you would now cause healing to come into my life. You would cause my body to be made well. If you're dealing with poverty, if you're dealing with need, you can say, Lord, on the basis of what Jesus did,when he died on the cross, that he took away, the Bible says, my poverty, and he brought me riches, that he became poor that I might become rich, then we can come and we can say, Lord, I'm asking for financial blessing to come into my life, because when Jesus died on the cross, he delivered me from the poverty spirit so that I can now receive of the abundance of everything that is supposed to be mine. So you can take...the provision of the cross, and you can present it as an evidence in the court of heaven. These are just some very simple ways to come and to stand in the courts and say, God, I'm bringing my case before you. I'm asking that which you've said about me might be done. Now, one more thing I would mention. In Daniel 7, verse 10, the Bible says the court was seated and the books were open. Now, one of the things you have to understand is that there's books in heaven.The Bible teaches that there's books of remembrance. There's books of prophecy. There's books about nations. There's all sorts of books in heaven. But one of the books in heaven is our own personal book. Psalms 139:16. David said, all my substance yet unformed, all my days yet unfashioned, they're written down in a book. So your destiny, your purpose for being alive in the earth,was actually written in a book before you ever existed in the earth. So when we, by prophetic understanding, realize what's in our book, we come and we present our case to the Lord. In other words, that's why it says the court was seated and the books were open, because you're going to present your case out of the books that contain your prophetic destiny. So I come and I say, Lord, this is what I'm alive for on the earth. This is why I'm here.I'm asking that this would become a reality. I'm asking that I could begin to move into this realm of life, into this dimension, into this livelihood, into this profession, into this breakthrough. Lord, I'm asking that this would become a reality because you wrote this in my book before time began, and you began to present your case based on what you're discerning prophetically that's in the book of heaven about you. So those are just some natural, easy things we can do to stand before the courts of heaven and begin to petition the courts and ask for that which God has promised us to be able to be a reality in our life.
我们又如何知道撒旦在天上法庭对我们的控告？ Robert 告诉我们，可以透过耶稣的宝血为我们申诉。
When we go into the courts of heaven, sometimes, in fact, many times, there's a case against us. I will say this, anybody that has a prophetic destiny, anybody that has a reason that God has created you and you're alive on the planet, that's the reason you're alive, which means all of us. In other words, if you're a human being and you're alive on the planet, God created you with a prophetic destiny. See, that's what it says in Ephesians 2:10. It says that we are his workmanship. We're created in Christ Jesus unto good works that were planned beforehand that we should walk them out. So literally, if you're alive on the planet, God made a plan about you. So the devil wants to stop that plan. And the reason he wants to stop that plan is because he knows if you get your destiny, then God's purpose is going to be done in the earth. You see, the devil's not trying to stop you from getting your destiny because he wants you to be unhappy. That's not the reason. The reason he wants to stop you from getting what's in the book of heaven about you, the destiny God made you for, is because he knows if he can stop you, if he can stop me, then he can stop the purpose of God from being fulfilled in the earth. Because the purpose of God being fulfilled in the earth is what our destinies are connected to. So what that means is that the enemy is going to, I promise you, he is going to build a case against you. Anybody that has a prophetic destiny, which is all of us, there is going to be a case against you. You have to know how to answer that case. See, again, this is what happened to Peter in Luke 22:31. Jesus said to Peter, Simon, Simon, Satan has desired to have you that he might sift you as wheat. That word desired literally means he has demanded you be put on trial. You see, somehow or other, Satan had an awareness of what that Peter's destiny was to change the world. And that if he didn't stop him from getting his destiny, Peter was going to change the world, which he in fact did. But so his strategy for stopping Peter from getting his destiny was to build a case against him. Jesus said he's demanded a trial date. He's demanded the right to come and present evidence against you. But Jesus said, but I prayed for you. Now, Jesus did not do that as God. He did that as a human being. You see, he did that as a man filled with God. Because when he walked the earth, Jesus never did a miracle as God. He only did miracles as a man filled with God, even though he was God. Philippians 2 says he laid aside his godhood and lived with the same limitations on him that you and I do. So when he prayed for Peter, he prayed for him from the position of being a human being. In other words, I'm saying this to say that Jesus stood in the courts as a human being, not as God. So that means that we have to also know how to go into the courts and deal with any and every case that is against us that the enemy would bring. Because this is the chief way that the enemy stops us from coming into our purpose and destiny. And one of the signs that this is happening to you is there's a frustration in you that you can never quite get into the fullness of what you know you were made for. That you have this intuitive sense that you were made for more than what God actually, than what you've been able to come into. That's usually because there's a case against you that won't let you get into the fullness of your purpose. It seems like every time you start to get into your purpose, something sabotages it and you get knocked back. See, that's because there's a repeating pattern. Because the enemy has found a legal right to stop you from your destiny, to stop you from coming into the fullness of what God has for you. You have to know how to go before the courts of heaven and to present before the courts of heaven, the blood of Jesus that is speaking in your behalf. See, the way you answer any and every accusation the devil has against you is through the blood of Jesus. Hebrews 12:24 says that there is a blood of sprinkling that is speaking better things than that of Abel. And if we can take the blood of Jesus, then we can stand and we can repent for ourselves. We can repent for our bloodline. We can repent for anything that our ancestors might have done, because that's one of the chief things the enemy uses. And we can ask for the blood to speak. And as the blood speaks, it silences the accusings of the accuser and causes those things to be annulled and washed away so that he can no longer legally use those things against us. And now we are free to come into the destiny and into the purpose that God made us for. So go before the courts in faith. Go before him in simplicity and just simply say, Lord, I'm asking for the blood of Jesus to speak for me. I'm asking for it to speak in behalf of me and my family. And any accusation that he's bringing, Lord, I'm asking for your blood to silence it and revoke its right to speak against me. And let me have the fullness of what I was made for in Jesus' name.
透过四天的特会，参与的弟兄姐妹不仅更了解自己有进入天上法庭的属灵权柄，也盼望台湾兴起更多代祷者，为国家走入上帝的命定代求。